Good morning, dear students. Today we will discuss about the turbocharger. Okay, so both supercharger and turbocharger are both are boosting the engine only, but some components are different. Okay, as the name indicates, charger means to boost the engine efficiency. Okay, na. So what do you mean by turbocharger? So exact what is the meaning? So turbocharger, or it is a turbo, from the here a turbine driven force induction device that increases an internal combustion engine's efficiency and power output for the forcing the extra air into the combustion chamber. The main function of this is it will send a extra air in the combustion chamber so that the engine efficiency can be boosted, okay, na? And also the power output can be get maximum. So that is the meaning of turbocharger. Okay, so it has shown in the diagram also the turbocharger component. Okay, so what is a turbocharger? Say it is a turbo is a centrifugal compressor powered by a turbine that is driven by an engine exhaust gases. Here two components are using, that is compressor and turbine. With the help of turbine we are forcing the fuel into the engine cylinder. Okay, now the main and its benefits lies within compressor increase the mass of an air entering into the engine and thereby as a resulting in a greater performance we can get from the engine cylinder. Okay, now there are popular use of an internal combustion engine, and these turbochargers are used in a popular IC engines. Okay, so these are the components. Here the complete diagram for the turbocharger. The turbochargers having the there are three main components. First one is a turbine, compressor and center housing. It is a hub rotating the assembly. Turbine, as you know, turbine almost is always in radial flow, inflow turbine, and compressor, which is almost all the centrifugal compressor we are using in all the turbocharger. Okay, na? Center hub or center housing, it is a rotating part of a turbine. Okay, now what are the main objective of this using turbocharger? The main objective of turbocharger is to improve the engine volumetric efficiency by increasing the intake density. That is the first one. Second one is the compressor draws in ambient air and it will compress it before it enters into the intake manifold at increased pressure, so that we can get a greater mass of an air entering into the cylinder on each intake stroke, so that we can get a more power. So third one is the power needed to spin the centrifugal compressor is derived from the high pressure and temperature of the engine exhaust gases. So the fourth one is the turbine converts the engine exhaust potential pressure energy into kinetic energy, then it into rotational power, which is in turn used to drive the compressor. Okay, now from the compressor we can send to the cylinder. Okay, so this is in how it will work, turbocharging principle. Okay, now the working is the air is pressurized by the compressor. So here normally the air is compressed or pressurized in the compressor. Or second step is the air cooler brings the air to a high density to the engine by decreasing the temperature. Here one more cooler is used, okay, now to cool the air fuel mixture. Okay, now third working is it is a part of an exhaust gases energy treated in the by the gases in the turbine. Okay, what we got in the energy in the turbine that will send to the rotor. So here the arrow indication also there. The turbine power is transmitted to the compressor through rotating shaft. The turbine, what we get the fuel in the turbine that will passes through the compressor, and they will compress, they will send to the engine cylinder. Okay, now see the arrow mark also. The engine can work at a high power density without increase in the thermal load. So this is about the working of turbocharging. Here nothing but both supercharger and turbocharger working is similar, but here there are two components are using. So compressor and turbine, from the turbine it will drive the forces, it sent to the compressor, from the compressor it go into the engine cylinder, and sometime here some filters also used, that is cooler also used to cool the engine cylinder. But where in the supercharger that centrifugal supercharger is connected to the engine directly, but here not connected directly to the engine. So that is the main difference. Okay, both are used for boosting the engine or power output only. So here the turbine, here the what is the main function of turbine in a turbocharger? So the turbine housing direct the gas flow through the turbine, and it will spin about 250,000 rpm. okay, the turbine and impeller wheel sizes also dictate the amount of an air or exhaust that can flow through a system, and then relative efficiency which can be operate very easily. Okay, now in general a larger of the turbine wheel and the compressor wheel large the flow of capacity. Here I shown here some turbine component in the diagram. Okay, so compressor, the compressor increases the mass of intake air entering into the combustion chamber. So it will increase the main function of compressor to will increase the mass of intake air into the combustion chamber. The compressor is made up of an impeller or diffuser and a valued housing also. Okay, now this is a compressor. So why turbochargers are used? So as you know, and as this results in a greater mass of air entering into the cylinder on a each intake stroke. So how many number of cylinder are there? So that much of air will enter equally distributed very within a short period and it will flow very smooth. The power needed to spin the centrifugal compressor is derived from the kinetic energy of the engine to the exhaust gases. And this turbocharger may also be used to increase the fuel efficiency without increasing the power. So without increasing the engine power, we can increase the fuel efficiency also. And these are widely used in almost all the car and commercial vehicles because they allow smaller capacity engine to have improved fuel economy and reduce the emission, higher power and power considering the higher torque, and also torque will be generated more. So some of the advantages of by using turbocharger is the power can be developed more. That is, if power or size, it allows for smaller engine displacement to produce a much more power relative to their engine size. And good performance in very high load. We will get a very good performance even at a high load also, and more suitable for high output engine also, and significantly increase the horsepower also. What are the disadvantages? Means normally as compared to this, it is very costly and complexity, and detonation will take and space is required large, and turbo lag with their turbocharger maintenance is very high. We have to check every day. So these are some applications. Almost it is used in petrol car, diesel car, motorcycle, trucks, aircraft. So the main difference between turbocharger and supercharger is here turbocharger three extra components are using, that is turbine and compressor, but here we are not using. So it uses the exhaust stream for its energy that runs through a turbine that itself spins the compressor, but here it uses a crankshaft for its energy and to produce the power of the engine. Second one difference is it is not directly connected with the engines, but it is directly connected with an engine and through which a V-belt can be used to transmit the power. So diagram also I shown here. This is the main two difference between the supercharger and turbocharger. So thank you. I hope you understand this concept. Thank you very much.